Historically, Minneapolis City Council seats are stable. The person in them rarely changes. U of M political professor Larry Jacobs predicts that won't be the case Tuesday night.
There is a strong feeling in Minneapolis that some of the incumbents who pushed hard on public safety, talked about defunding the police, have gone too far. There are also some races where the incumbents who oppose those things are facing a lot of criticism.
Jacobs thinks as many as four wards could see new representation. That's a difference maker for the 13-member body made up of Democrats who don't always get along.
It's particularly on the liberal or left wing of the Democratic Party that we're seeing a battle royale.
In a shift, Jacobs calls some candidates more moderate or pragmatic, like Emily Kosky, who opposes dismantling the police department, unlike Jeremy Schrader, who she's trying to unseat in Ward 11, the southernmost part of the city.
The country is wondering what is going on in Minneapolis, and will it embrace a very sharp turn towards a new approach to public safety, or will it have a second thought and instead kind of have a mid-course correction?
He says the tightly contested races means it's likely we won't know all the results Tuesday night. What he does know is all eyes will be on Minneapolis.
I think the Minneapolis city council races are getting unusual attention because they're seen as a bellwether for the direction of the Democratic Party.
Jacobs also says it's very hard to predict city council races because usually the number of voters just isn't very large. And this year, Minneapolis, in fact, has seen a record number of early voters, which he says is making it even more difficult to tell just whose supporters are showing up. Randy?
Thank you. Stay with Care 11 for live team coverage of the election. We have a full election guide online, and we'll post the results on our digital platforms as soon as they come in. Plus, we'll have a full breakdown of the results and the big races tomorrow on Care 11 News at 10.